See, we are actually doing one of the few of the most difficult questions from this chapter, okay? So, you can see that difficulty level of the most difficult question is not very high. So, it's a very scoring chapter, do it properly. In fact, this entire chapter is all about sign convention. Once you get your sign convention right, you will be able to solve any question. You have a concave or convex lens made up of glass of refractive index 1.5 and has surfaces of radii 20 cm and 60 cm. Okay? Fine. Initially, you had only one lens. This was not there. Initially, you had only one lens. Okay? So, if you place an object 80 cm to the left of the lens, as in the object is here, 80 cm. Fine? You need to locate the image of this object. So, basically, your observer is here. This is your observer, this is your object. Light from the object should reach the observer. This lens is not there right now. Okay? Find the location of image. Okay, what do you do here? How to solve this question? This is a lens. Okay, this is a thin lens. So our usual tendency is to use the lens formula 1 by V minus 1 by U equals to 1 by F. Right? But we don't know what is F. For that, we have to use lens mega formula. Okay? So do not find out F and then substitute here 1 by F. Find 1 by F only and directly substitute here. Getting what I am trying to say? Unnecessarily you divide it and you find out F and then you anyway finding 1 by F and putting it here. Anybody got the answer? Anyone?
Sorry, 240.
240. Okay, let us quickly solve this. 1 by F will be equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by mu 1 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So when I substitute here 1.5 minus 1 divided by 1 1 by 20 minus 1 by 60. How much is this? 1 by F is 1 by 60. 1 by 60. 1 by 60. Okay, so this nice number comes, so whether you substitute F or 1 by F doesn't matter. But at time what will happen, you get 1 by F, suppose, you know, suppose you get 0.345. So do not invert it and then put here. You directly get 1 by F, directly substitute 1 by F here. So 1 by V minus, what is U? Minus 80. So this is minus 80 and this is 1 by 60. So V comes out to be 240 centimeters. This is what it is. Okay? Now what you are doing it, doing here, you are putting another lens. A similar lens you are putting here at a distance of 160 centimeters. Okay? And your observer is now here looking at things. Where is the image now? Anyone got? How much? 48. From where?
From the second.
From the second edge. What you are getting?
Sir, I'm just talking. 48
is
not
correct.
This is
80. What? 80. No. Give sign convention. Okay, do one thing. Draw a red diagram. It will really help you. If you draw a ray diagram, take a point object, don't take extended object. From here, the image of that will be 240 cm. So it will try to form an image somewhere over here, whose distance is 240. Fine, but it is not able to do that. So what will happen? Light will further converge because it's converging planes. Will converge like this, so final image will be here somewhere. This is initial image, I1 and that is I2. So I2 is where the actual image gets formed. I1 is the first image. This I1 is the object of this lens. Anyone now? How do we know it is converging lens? Because focal length comes out to be positive. It converges a parallel rays forward. That is the focal length is positive. That is why it is converging. What do you got? 245. That is approximately how much? No. No. Anybody else? Any other answer?
80 centimeters.
80? No. See, 80 is anywhere here. This I1 is anywhere 80 centimeters from here. Isn't it? This is what? 80 centimeters only. I2 has to be less than 80 because it further converges. Yeah, yeah, both are same. Identical. What are you getting? 80.
245/7.
You are also getting 245/7. Getting 20. Okay, so you can talk among yourselves, see where.
What you are getting?
What are you getting?
Still 48.
48. Hmm. Should I do it now? Lens formula is what? 1 by V minus 1 by U equals to 1 by F. Now V is what we need to find out. What is U? U is what for this? Huh? 80. Or minus 80? 80. So this is plus 80. Why? Because object is that side. Okay? F is what? F is 60. Oh, you guys did, you guys made error in addition.
Sir, what? Sir, you suddenly made it 60. Sir, that's definitely 7.2.
So, V is 8 plus 6 is 14. No, but in axioma, what is written is find a thin lens of focal length. Plus 12 centimeter. Okay, this is the focal length given. Now this lens is immersed in water of refractive index 4 by 3. What is the new focal length? How much it is? Focal length in air is given. Focal length of this lens in air is given. We need to find focal length in water. So if I change the refractive index of medium, will focal length change? It should change, right? It depends on the medium's refractive index also. Mu 1 is medium's refractive index. We have 1 by F equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 by mu 1, 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So we have to use this. So in case number 1, it is air, the surrounding. So 1 by F, which is 1 by 12 is equal to mu 2 is, let us say mu minus 1 divided by mu, sorry, divided by 1 only, 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. Okay, we need to find out what is f in case the refractive index of the medium becomes 4/3. Have you taken mu as 1.5? Okay, so it is not given, but it should have been. So we'll take mu as 1.5. So when you substitute here 1.5, this
we can just take it like that.
No. Oh. It will not help.
No, but like sir, in the sense like I thought we had to find the u2 and then substitute it to the thing and then.
No, you have this 1/r1 minus 1/r2 is also variable. Fine. You have f also variable. You have only two equations. You can't make another variable.
I took that 1/r1 minus 1/r2.
So this u divide. Once you divide, these will go away.
So then it's easy, sir. Okay. So like I.
Yeah, it should be given. The refractive index of material should be given. So it is 1.5. Okay. Fine. So this completes the another section of your chapter, which deals with lenses. Okay.